Good morning, folks, and welcome. I've put a fresh needle in it, I've wound it up, had to wind it up with my electric drill. battery drill. Did it slowly, though, because it's not conducive to wind a gramophone up with a drill. But I haven't got a starting handle for it yet, so let's drop this onto the record. There we go. Finally working. Thanks to Jay providing me with that replacement Garrard motor. I've got to put the motor. I've got to clean out the motor board. Wait for Jay to next visit me and bring me a starting handle, and I'm going to ask him to bring the original turntable as well, because this is the turntable off the other mech, and I've had to put a bit of heat shrink tubing in because the other spigot was a bit thicker. So it works. It's not perfect, But there's a bit of wow and flutter there, a slight speed variation, and the reason why is the turntable's not balanced. It's warped and it's slightly out of shape, and that's throwing it off balance, because without the turntable on, when you look at the governor on the motor, the speed's rock solid. There's no variation at all, so it's just caused through the turntable. But Jay did say he's got the original turntable. He didn't think I needed it, because like me, he thought that most gramophone turntables were standard. So, you know, but clearly not all of them are, so he's going to drop that on his next visit. I'll have a word with him about that. And he's going to drop me off a starting handle. He thought I had a handle, but I haven't, so I put a bolt in here, which is the same thread pitch, and I wound it up with me electric, with me battery drill. Shouldn't really wind a gramophone up that way, but you know, there was no way I was sitting there with a little screwdriver turning an Allen bolt. So, and I couldn't find me socket set wrench, otherwise I'd have done it with that. But anyway, it works. It can be cleaned out inside. All the screws for around here are all inside there. This mechanism has gone in beautifully. I've had to drill another hole in the side here because the winder was in a different place. So, you know, you can't avoid that. But yeah, I'm really glad the way this has turned out. It's not bad. And, you know, I'll give it a bit of a polish up and whatnot, make it look nice, and probably have it in my front room on display or somewhere. Yeah. Anyway, I'm probably gonna get a copy strike for the Mario Lanza record, but who gives a fuck? You know. I mean, you've got to be able to demonstrate the stuff when you've repaired it, and you know, thanks for watching this this series, rather unusual non-electronics series from Vintage Electronics. You know, but yes, like I say, I'm really, really happy with it. It's working really, really good. The motor, you know, if you watch the other video, the motor's been stripped. I didn't do anything with the springs. I didn't take the spring drums apart, because it's a double spring, this, as you know from watching the other video. This is a double spring. It's a Garrard Junior number 5, the motor, and it'll play two records on a single wind. I mean, in all fairness, it's that also depends on how long the records are as well. If it's it'll play two standard 10-inch 78s and probably one and a half 12-inch, and there were some 7-inch 78s. They're very rare, but there were a few. Odd sizes, it'll probably play about 3 or 4 of those. Probably play 4 of those. But yeah, I'm happy with it. It's needs a good polish up. Is that a hole? No, it's just a mark. Needs a good polish up. But apart from that, yeah, we're done with the gramophone project. You know, like I say, I've done gramophone. You know, I've serviced a couple of gramophones before. Never done videos on them. There is actually a video I did. One of the first videos I ever did on my Columbia gramophone. I serviced that, but I didn't do a video servicing it. I just did a video of it playing a record. All being well, I'll have a handle for it soon. I'll be able to wind it up properly, and That's it, we're all done.
Yeah.
I'm yawning and all, but I woke up at 3 o'clock this morning, I couldn't get back to sleep, so I got up and started messing with this. The speed on it's not bad. The speed controller does work, and we're actually approximately about 78 here. Give or take a couple of revolutions. I haven't had a stroboscope disc on it, but there's no point till I get a proper turntable for it, because it's got that wow and flutter, so it's got that wow, so it wouldn't give me with that variation, it wouldn't give me an accurate speed reading anyway. So, but you know, I've got it as near as damn it with what I've got. So, you know, like I say, thanks to Jay for providing me with that. That thing wants to go now, looking the brakes on. But, you know, like I say, thanks to Jay for providing that replacement Garrard motor. It saved me bodging that spring up. The thing's still trying to go. I'm gonna switch it back on and let it, I'll take the brake off and let it run down. I don't really want to keep tension on the spring. Anyway, folks, it's not bad, that it's... It was fairly quiet. You know, it's not bad. I've heard them louder than that. Anyway, folks, thanks for watching, and bye for now. More to come later. Bye for now.